You can't see them, but it seems like every single spider in London has decided to make a web from left to right and be right in the middle. So Sunday outside is slightly delayed due to spiders.
As per usual, everything's a bloody battle for me, you know. There's a dog that's only just stopped barking in the background, but probably will start up again in a minute. There you go. There's a wind that's come from nowhere, as per. I've just got a massive delay getting out my own bloody back door because of a mass amount of spiders. I mean, there was only small spiders, to be fair. There was no big massive ones. Otherwise, this video would not be happening right now. But I don't particularly want to do a YouTube video crawling with loads of spiders. Anyway, gust of wind. And to finish it off, the printer's decided to run out of toner. So I've only been able to print off 5 of my last 10 videos this week. Anyway, so I'm going to rattle through this really, really quick because not only am I limited on time due to low battery and low memory card space, I've got to jump on a mega bus up to Hull because I'm going to Hull Fair this week. Is it this week? I always get confused when the weekends start. Well, tomorrow or Tuesday will be Hull Fair, so I'm really looking forward to that because I like fair. Inside, we're all kids at. We're just growing up with jobs. That's just what it is. I'm going to start with Chicago Town Crumble Desire Pizza. Saul Goodman. It's been a while since you've commented. Lol, MG from Food Review UK has to get this as well. You and him should collab. And that got 3 likes. Yeah, it'd be nice if it had happened, but I think there's a much less chance of that happening now because it's I don't live in Ilinden near Uxbridge anymore. And he lives in... I always forget where he lives. I always forget. Then people always come in. How can you forget this place? And I just do. James Gooden. I love these, but not quite as much as the normal pizza. They are amazing. Oh my God, massive bee! Oh, that bee was massive! Where the flipping heck has that gone? Flipping heck. That really, really scared me. Might have gathered. It was bloody huge. It nearly took me away. Good grief. No wonder people call me a pansy. I'm bloody attracting massive bees. Flipping heck, it must have thought I was a big flower wearing a green top. I knew it was a mistake wearing green. If it comes back, I'll probably just explode again. Where was I up to? Normal pizza. See, I'm really on edge now. If it isn't spiders, it's bees. We need bees. I like bees very much. If that was a wasp, can you imagine my reaction? This is not meant to be a reaction video. It's meant to be Sunday outside. Peaceful, calm, serene. Not leaping about like a gazelle on ecstasy. I think the bee is gone now. Yeah. Chicago Town Pizza, Luke Carrigan and James Gooden, yeah. Chicago Town best out the chocolate can, but Goodfellas. Yeah, there's a Goodfellas chocolate pizza, isn't there? But I'm not a fan of chocolatey pizzas as such, but the Chicago Town little ones were quite good. Gust of wind. Sally Button. Hi Charlie, not for me. I'm not saying it's not tasty, but for me pizza has to be savoury all the way and pepperoni if I can get it. Well, that's true. I tried the macaroni and cheese Chicago Town pizza, not the Iceland one, which I'm meant to be doing a review on. We'll get round to it eventually. But the Chicago Town macaroni cheese ones are really good. The limited edition, I don't think they're a limited edition just to Iceland either. I think they're just limited edition. But I was really surprised how nice they were because they actually tasted really nice. The cheese wasn't powdery like I was expecting. You know, like on the awful Kraft meal things that I reviewed and the cheese was like really powdery tasting, that really low quality. They were really good. Lizzie Bunny W. Are you the same? Have you changed your name or is this somebody new? At the end, when I put everyone's always commented at the end, they're not Patreon. They're actually people who've just commented on my videos. I've written you one just in case you are somebody new. Otherwise, it's a really sneaky way to get your name on twice on the credits at the end. I've had Domino's pizza about 3 times in the last week because I'm being busy and couldn't be bothered to make my tea. And I remembered your review on Domino's pizza chocolate thing and considered getting it. Then I remembered another chocolate pizza review and it looked disgusting. It doesn't seem right to me to have pizza as a dessert. I've always realised I've spelt Domino's pizza the wrong way. Oh, well, never mind. Yeah, I think we've all done that at some point. But, yeah, pizza for dessert, it's just not right, is it? I mean, I can imagine some really cross Italians, you know, saying, of all the desserts we make, what are Americans and the British doing, you know? Can't have a proper Italian dessert, not a pizza dessert, amalgamation. It's another, a lovely word, isn't it? Amalgamation. Potassium permanganate. Permanganate. Thuggy. Sweet pizza. What witchcraft is this? Exactly, exactly. Hang on, my nose is itching. I don't like doing that on camera. It's like burping, isn't it? It's just rude. All these trees, not one of them turned into toilet roll for my nose. Amazing, isn't it? Maurice Thompson, Have you tried the Made in Italy? Oh, I should look up more, shouldn't I? Otherwise I'm doing a Theresa May where she's constantly looking down and coughing. You know, I don't have them letters behind me. Can you imagine if my scratch letters started falling off in the background of me studio that I'm still working on? Have you tried a Made in Italy pepperoni, red onion and chili pizzas? They are yummy and only £1.69 in Iceland. I've not tried them yet, no, but I've probably tried some sort of variant of that. I mean, I did work in Iceland for a very long time. In my very long time terms. Charlotte, how much weight did you lose in the veganism? I totally forgot to weigh myself at the end, didn't I, of the video? Because I was just so looking forward to having a mac and cheese. But I lost about a stone. I lost about a stone. And I've probably put half of that back on now. I just don't have the time. I mean, wind. I don't have the time, you know, I'm at work, then I rush home, watch The Chase and Tipping Point, rush off to work again, come home, and starving hungry, slam something in the microwave, go to sleep, wake up stupidly early, come back home, watch Tipping Point, The Chase, go back out to work. That's what it's like. I don't understand. It feels like lots of people just seem to have the time to have fun and I don't. And then, I just don't know where people get the time from. I really don't. Because these don't take much time. I mean, the lengthiest time's editing, and especially Sunday outside, doing all the words at the end. I'm starting to rattle on, and I nearly forgot I do actually have a bus to catch, Megabus. Which reminds me about lateness. I always like to be a couple of hours early. I mean, it doesn't leave London St Pancras, because the first part of it's still the train, but it's all included as Megabus. It doesn't leave until 3:10. But I will be there. I will be there for 1:00. And it really bugs me how people turn up. I hate rushing. I always set off stupidly early. And sometimes when you do that, you can still be cutting it fine. And it has happened before. But at least I knew I still made it. I had to rush onto that train. And as soon as I slammed the train door shut, that train took off. Which makes no sense because it's on rails. But you know what I mean. At least I did everything that I could possibly have done to get there. But some people just saunter around, don't they? Oh, what do you mean I've missed my train? What do you mean? What do you mean I've missed my train? What do you mean? What do you mean? Check-in's closed at the airport. Get there early. Set off stupid. Allow yourself a stupid amount of time, because you know what? There's a lot of people in the world that want to be somewhere, and the earlier you are and the more sporadic everyone sets themselves out, the less stress there'll be. Anyway, sweet pizza, blah, 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 blah. Mark McCurry, not a big fan of dessert pizza, however, it's pretty okay with a dollop of ice cream. I should have had it with ice cream, shouldn't I? And it might have mellowed out the bready sweet bit at the bottom, the dough. Moving on to sparkling ice review, Scottish Ever, 2:19. I need to figure out where the mic is on this, what effects by the wind. I got a vision of the future, and this video had been used in some kind of flashback news article about how the world was the way back when. I think that's when I hold things up to the camera when I'm doing a food review and I say smell, you know. Because it's going to happen one day. People used to laugh, didn't they, when they said, oh, sound on video will never take off, and oh, colour will never take off. Okay, people was right about 3D TV. I mean, that just never really caught on, did it? 3D TV in the home, and it's alright for the odd film and everything, but do you really want to watch Coronation Street, EastEnders or Emmerdale in 3D? Who cares? Who cares if Rita Sullivan in the cabin is handing you a newspaper and it leaps out the screen at you? You can do that normally at a shop. You don't need to have the 3D glasses on or the 3D anything at all. So I was trying to think of other examples that would be pointless. Even football. I mean, I'm no football fan, as you gathered from a Wayne Rooney video. But so do you really want to see a football pitch and some lazy ass footballer who can't be bothered to run, who was getting paid millions of pounds a year just doing this? Spit. I can't spit on camera. It's disgusting. You don't want to see that. In 3D, you don't want to be there. That's why 3D never really took off, in my opinion. You might have other reasons why you think it didn't continue. Mr. Nauticat, you can buy some of these in 4-packs in Sainsbury's. That's a sparkling ice. You can get them in a 4-pack, can you? I didn't know that, Mr. Nauticat. Darcy May, how many fluid ounces is there in 500ml? I have no idea. It's a really funny thing, measurements, weights and measures and everything in the UK, because we are nearly all metric, but not in everything. And for instance, me particularly, I still like to weigh myself in stones and pounds, because stones, smaller numbers are better numbers. So I'd rather be 15 stone something rather than hundreds of pounds or many kilograms. Ugh. You know what I mean? But metric is really easy. It's so easy. And you instantly know how much you're getting and how much there isn't. And just by looking at something, you can pretty much gauge how far away it is or something. Yeah, so unfortunately, I never bothered to learn the conversion because I've never needed to. My mum and dad did their generation, so people in the 40s and 50s and 60s and so on, they'll have needed to know that information. But I think if you're in your 30s, 20s, teenagers now, there's no need to know the conversion unless you're going to America or to other little tiny countries in the world that don't do metric. Then it's going to be a pain in the derriere. I mean, fluid ounces and what's the other one? I don't know. They don't sound better, don't they? Gallons is a lovely word. I'll have 5 gallons of booze, please. Rather than litres. Litres just doesn't sound very grand, does it? We'll have a litre. I'll have a gallon. Anyway. S125-ish. You can get these in Sainsbury's, usually for £1. Only 2 flavours, the peach one and the raspberry and black one. I know it's really difficult to get the sparkling ice drinks all in the full range, but Boots had it. That's why I got them from Boots. Luke Carrigan, GB, that's a bloody throwback. Surprised I still make it. Was always far inferior to Robinson's. Not just overall, but taste-wise. Yeah, GB is really weird, isn't it? Because it was the really cheap one that was probably bought at your school party and stuff, but it was still better than the value tat that you get from the supermarkets. But GB juice, there was orange pineapple and something it's called, and it really is good. I can't remember it. Orange pineapple and something. I think it's peach. Orange pineapple and peach. I can't remember. It's not easy to find now either, annoyingly. Luke Carrigan again. Show the colour of the kiwi and strawberry would indicate the focus on kiwi. I think because the flavour combos, it's hard for them to get both flavours. Well, strawberry and kiwi is usually clear when I've bought it from, like, Sainsbury's or Tesco or Asda or Morrison's. You know, in the 1-litre bottles that's 55p, 60p, 70p, or two for a pound sort of stuff. So they're usually clear. So I think maybe that's emphasising the water then, because they are quite watered down. Ben Edwards, when it says kiwi and strawberry, they put kiwi first because it's going to taste more like kiwi, and the ingredients list, it will probably have kiwi first. Well, it did have kiwi, didn't it? And had strawberry, not at all. Wow Pop, Boots Mill Deals are the best. Morrison's is good too, and apparently they've added more things to the range, which is good. I am a very big fan of meal deals when they're good, because quite often meal deal is neither a meal or a deal, and WH Shit is a perfect example of that. WH Shit, if you don't know, is a newsagent, bookshop, stationery, general tat merchandiser in the UK that's 250 years old now, some stupid amount of age, and it's really surprising it's managed to survive so bloody long, because it's a far, far shadow of its former self. WH Smith himself must be, well, he can't be spinning in his grave, because I think after nearly 300 years, I think he's pretty much dust now, but which, if that sounds cruel, I mean, it's life, isn't it? Maybe the worms are spinning in their graves, do you know? It must be so disgusted what the company has become. There's pictures of it, because there's a great thing on Twitter called at @WHS_carpet, which is just takes the piss out of WH Smith. It's hilarious. And in some of the airports, £8 for a meal deal. £8. Bog off. It's so incredibly eye-wateringly, disgustingly overpriced, WH Smith. I hate that place with a passion. I used to work there, if you've not watched any of my videos before. I do not have a single good thing to say about that company. It is a mess. Its last chance of being a heyday was in the 1990s. Since the 1990s, it's just been a running joke of the high street. If it went bust tomorrow, there'd actually be more jobs on the high street, because they're actually in really good locations. So it would be taken over overnight, and everyone's jobs would probably just be taken over by the new company. It's just a waste of space. I think I've made my point. Oh, it was a leaf falling on my head. That was either a leaf of a future book that's going to be sold in WH Smith patting me on the head saying thank you for that, we don't want to end up in WH Smith, or it was something else. Michael J, these are four for a pound in Heron. I think Heron may be a northern food shop, though. It is. In the scale of things, of frozen food shops, at the top is Iceland, obviously. Then you've got Farm Foods, which is grim. Then you've got Heron, which is grim, but it's got cheap chic about it, in my opinion. I prefer Heron more than Farm Foods. Heron, I might be a bit biased in that, because it's based very in much where I'm from, East Yorkshire. So I am probably a bit biased in that, but I do like Heron. They've smartened the shops up a lot recently as well, because they used to be really quite grim. I think Farm Foods now is the more downbeat of the three. Oh, yes, two pages. Oh, I love her, 95. It's just soda. The word sparkling in the description is the giveaway. Carbonated foods destroy enzymes in the stomach and that allow digestion of food. Killing those enzymes means people get fatter and they don't process foods in the natural pace. Pardon me. The flavours sound good, though. I love it. It's so funny. She's like, slags funny. Slags off the fizzy drinks, but the flavours sound good. you can say that about normal citrus drinks. Orange juice and lemon juice, natural, is terrible for your stomach. That does exactly the same thing. Fresh orange juice, if you were to drink too much of that, and too much can be as little as like a pint of it, is really bad for your stomach. Full of delicious vitamin C, you know, so it's good for you, but just terrible for your stomach. Moving on now to Vegan Eats. Oh, this was like last Sunday's outside, and there's loads of comments on it. So I'm going to go through everyone who's commented on it, which is Otterlover95, Lizzie Bunny W, Mark McCorry, Lizzie Bunny W, Wow Pop, Luke Carrigan, Samantha Williams, Richie Sayers, Mugger UK, Jane UK, Graham Tull, Katie, Sally Button, Adam Fitzpatrick, Young Retro Gamer, and I think that was everyone. If I've missed anyone off, which I'm sure I have, because I'm sure it was 3 pages. Thank you all for coming in, and thank you everyone for your support. I will be very rarely talking about that vegan month because I don't want to bang on about it too much. This is hopefully the last time I'll refer to it, but thanks to everyone for your support, who gave support, obviously. It was definitely a time of my life I'm definitely going to remember. And generally not in positive ways, but there's some positive things that come out of it. There's some foods that I like. Linda McCartney sausages, as you probably gathered. And what else was there? You want the Linda McCartney burgers, the pulled pork fake burger sort of things. They was alright, weren't they? And the Alpro yogurt alternative. That was nice. Right, so moving on to caviar crisps. That was an expensive crisps, but it was like £4 for that bag, weren't they? I did eat them all. They did all go. Matt N, £4 for those. Fuck that. 3 likes for that. You what? Yeah, I've got my keys, yeah. See ya. And, £4 for a bag of crisps, but the caviar crisps actually improved in flavour as I ate them, and after I'd eaten them all, the flavour was much more substantial. Which means, if you was to buy a pack and divvy them out for people, hang on a minute, nose is running, they probably won't get the full flavour, which would have been very, very boring. Has the cat made an appearance today? I don't know. How long have we been rattling on for? 21 minutes. Really need to get pushing on. Lizzie Bunny W. Haha, it must be with the same company as the Tours coaches I've seen in Spain. It's in Spanish too. So where they're not making money, they decided to sell overpriced posh crisps instead. And that'd be really funny, wouldn't it? You know, a bus company not making any money. Do you know what? Let's go into crisps. Which doesn't sound as bizarre as you'd first think. Because R&R, which is like, I think, it's either the UK's or the world's biggest ice cream producer, one of the two, or whatever it is. They had nought to do with ice cream originally. Originally, their main job was selling bull sperm. There you are, and that's actual fact. It's very weird, isn't it? I mean, how do you get from bull sperm to making ice cream? Chewbacca, good to see the food reviews are back. I know, it's nice to do food reviews. It's nice to have a reason to eat something different. I like trying new things. Sally Button. Hi Charlie, my pet hit, half a bag of crisps. Yours are an exorbitant price of £4. Don't care if they are caviar. I, for one, won't be paying that price no matter how nice they are. That is so true. It really feels like a fly's flew up my nose or something. It is a ridiculous amount for a bag of potatoes, isn't it? Well, no, £4 for a bag of potatoes, if the bag was big enough, is actually quite good. But sliced ones. Luke Carrigan. Doritos, 110 gram, OMG. Just as I began that, you said Doritos, 110 gram, OMG. Just as I began that, you said Doritos. Anyway, would rather buy them for a pound. I know this and I don't even eat crisps anymore. Hashtag sweet tooth. If that didn't make sense when I read that out, it's because I'm just not making sense. I'm really getting into my head now that I really need to get this done, edited, saved, uploaded before I set off. Gareth Wilby. Where are you, Charlie? I assume somewhere up north as your accent is a bit like mine. That's Gareth Wilby. I'm from Hull, East Yorkshire. My accent, if anything, has got stronger since I moved to London. That's because I don't listen. Because there's so much bullshit you've got to listen to when you move down here. You know, everything's automated, you know, and you just want to get through your own life without other people getting in the way of it too much. You know, it's, for instance, you're crammed together on the tube and you just want to blank out other people, you know, put your earphones in. Get through the day, get through the journey. I don't think my accent's changed very much at all. I watch sometimes my older videos, not because I like watching myself at all, I really don't, But I watch my older videos from like 2012 and some of the really old stuff because there's some old bits of it languishing from earlier that I long since deleted off of YouTube. This is the point where people are going to say, oh, upload this, upload that. No, no. Because it's filmed off my old laptop, off the webcam, before I even had a camera. And it looks so foggy. It had ground every plane in the world and they wouldn't even fly through it. James got an HD. Looking at Fortnum and Mason prices after this video, as I'd never heard of it. Don't bother, Charlie, unless you want to be way, it's way expensive. Just don't worry about it. James Gordon, I do like a challenge. Even if you have to buy the cheapest thing from there. I can't be a food reviewer and not at least once go to Fortnum and Mason. And I mean, I've been to Selfridges and I have not been to Harrods. I've only been to Harrods once since I moved to London. I need to go back. I need to go in there. Probably get scowled at again. I had really bad customer service in there. I was made to feel so gutter. It is untrue. And I don't get it because many, many, many millionaires and rich people dressed like a bag of rags and you'd never know they was worth millions or billions of pounds. Anyway. Thuggy, I buy caviar sometimes. I like it on baked potatoes. Gosh, that'd be lovely. I don't like caviar. Obviously, I don't eat it very often at all. I think I've had it about 4 times in my life. And that's including on them crisps. Luke Carrigan. Just as I started my reply for this child, I said, do I look like the kind of person? And so I'm going to say, does he look like the kind of person who knows who Fernando Torres is? Fernando Torres. Fernando. It's a good Spanish and Italian sort of European name, isn't it? Fernando. I mean, very few people in the UK who were born in the UK are going to be called Fernando. I just think of the ABBA song. Rubicon Spring Drink New Flavour. I was going to say, I thought I'd already done that. Leslie Nunya. These look so similar to the sparkling ice drinks we have here in the US. I love them! Exclamation mark. And then obviously I did the sparkling ice drinks and she was really happy that I reviewed them because it's all made that up, well, as I said in the videos, you know, when drinks are made under license in another country, they never taste quite the same. So maybe if I go to one of them sweet shops who import stuff from America, they might randomly have an American version of it, mightn't they? Luke Carrigan, I don't pick these up if I'm desperate for a drink, sure they don't have aspartame either. I've been really loving blueberry muffin based products lately and hearing about them. Seen mini ones in Asda, which I was tempted to buy. It's a strange one, as if anything you'll see cranberry products as we approach Christmas. I'm not sure what season blueberries are common in, colour really stands out though, as you say. Yeah, blueberries more of a like strawberries, you know, it's meant to be more of a summer thing. I've just noticed how tall the daisies are in this garden. There's only two, but they're quite tall. Tall daisies. Lizzie Bunny W, I find these fizzy Rubicons very tasteless. I remember the review did of the spring water ones. Yeah, that was the other ones. The fizzy Rubicon. Yeah, I mean, the blueberry one was, but I mean, I can't remember now because it was such a long time ago when I reviewed the other four. So I can't really compare them. And that is everything. Thanks everyone for watching. Please scratch that in the comment section down below if anything I've spoken about today has made any sense at all. And hopefully there is no big bee or big spider preventing me from getting back into my own bloody abode. Thanks for watching, scratch. Bye. Oh, do you want to see the big daisies before I go? I mean, tall daisies, not big daisy. It's actually quite far off the floor. The ground. The floor. Oh, look at the state of this. Stupid spiders. I mean, what are they going to possibly catch in the middle of the door apart from me? They can't wind me up in the web.